In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Deacon Angel Palacios from the Orthodox Church in America, Diocese of Mexico, from the Mission of St. Andrew in Tijuana, Baja California, Mexico. The Gospel is for the 26th of October 2018, according to St. Luke. Do well, do what is good while we are alive. Jesus said to the crowds, "When you see a cloud rising in the west, you say immediately that it is going to rain. And so it does. And when you notice that the wind is blowing from the south, you say that it's going to be hot, and so it is. You hypocrites! You know how to interpret the appearance of the earth and the sky. Why do you not know how to interpret the present time? Why do you not judge for yourselves what is right? If you are to go with your opponent before a magistrate, make an effort to settle the matter on the way. Otherwise, your opponent will turn you over to the judge, and the judge hand you over to the constable, and the constable throw you into prison. I say to you, you will not be released until you have paid the last penny." Glory be to thee, O God, glory be to thee. Well, the Lord is talking to us about what we are going to do with our own lives. We squander our time. We squander our life. We are preoccupied with all so many things, whether what we are going to eat, what we're going to drink, where we're going to live, what kind of clothes we are going to wear, where we have to work, and then all the people that trouble us, or that we feel that they trouble us, all the people that will not agree with the way that we want them to be, all the people that act differently from us, all the people that are not similar to us, all the people that have other interests than us, and we hate. Sometimes we allow ourselves to hate, or we despise others. And that, all of that, along with the pleasures and the anxieties of the world, many times we dedicate ourselves to live the present and think that we have to be filled with pleasure, we feel with satisfaction and comfort, and we get blinded in our soul, the news of our soul gets blinded, and we are not looking for God anymore. And then we even dare to say that we're good because we're not stealing with nor killing anyone. But we are really not doing what we ought to do. We might be wearing a cross, but we are not living really like the Christ. And the Lord is telling us in the end, why do you not judge by yourself what is right, what is just? To do what is right. While we are alive, we are working with our opponents. Who are our opponents? Well, our own flesh, our desires, the world, when it takes us away from the Lord. And the devils, of course, the demons, they all push toward us. The devils, especially, would like to make slaves of us. And they are successful whenever we are enslaved by our own passions. Then is when they will throw us into jail, because we will be enslaved by the passions. So what do we need to do? We need to prepare and pray. First, we have to repent. But if we are not able to repent right now, then at least pray that God will grant you to repent and to see truly how you are in the eyes of Him, so that we might truly repent. And when we are repented, may God illumine our hearts, our minds, that we might start doing what is good within our lives. Because once we are dead, we will be thrown into prison. What does that mean? That we will be thrown into hell. There is no purgatory, you see. There is nowhere in the Holy Scriptures that say that you will remain there in a cleansing station for so many months or years or whatever. No, there's nothing like that. There's either heaven or hell. And prison is equal to hell. And then the Lord says, you will not get out until you pay the last penny. But how are you going to pay if there is nothing that you can actually do while you are dead and you are thrown into hell? Now, that is not going to happen to us immediately when we die. We rest in the Lord, and afterwards we will be judged. But if we are judged unworthy, we will be hurled headlong into hell. So what do we need to do? I beg you, dear brothers, to repent, to ask the Lord to help us, you and me, to do good deeds while we are alive.